Okay, so in this topic, we're going to see how can we use derived class pointer and references to call the member function of the derived class. And after covering this topic, I'm going to build a path where you're going to understand the need of virtual function in the base class or as well as in the derived class. Gradually, in the next lecture, we're going to discuss about the virtual function in detail, and we'll see how to achieve polymorphism with the help of virtual function. So in this lecture, so what are you going to learn in this lecture? We're going to learn in this lecture about the derived class pointer and references. Derived class pointer references. So what we have already covered, we have covered how to use inheritance to derive new class from existing class. We have seen so many examples over this topic, and when we create a derived class, we also saw that derived class object is composed of multiple part, one part for each inherited class. So whenever we created a derived object, it basically has two part. Suppose derived class D has derived from a base class B. So derived class object will have two part. First part will be the belong to the class from which the new class was inherited, and the last part of the derived class object will have its own parts. Okay, so I think you should remember this concept, how these two class we bind together inside the derived class object. There may be one question in our mind: can we use a base class pointer and reference with derived object? Answer is yes, we can use base class pointer and reference to point a derived class object. Let's see one example by which you'll get the idea, okay, about how to use base class pointer and references with the derived class. Okay, just go with this very basic example. We have created a class called base as a base class, and there is a one data member m underscore value declared as protected. Then we have a one argument constructor here called base, and we are using initializer list to initialize the data member of the base class. Thereafter, we have written two function belongs to the base class. One function that we have designed, we called it getName, which will return the name of the class. So it will return the name of the class is base. And we have designed another function called getValue, which is going to return the value of m underscore value. Okay, so normally we call them getter method in C++. Next, we have derived a class called derived, and we have inherited it from the base class, and we are using here public mode of inheritance. Now look at this derived class. It is very simple and straightforward. Derived class has no data member. Derived class has as a constructor here. So we are calling the base class constructor from the derived class constructor to initialize the base part of the derived object. Thereafter, we are using two methods. Look at the name of the method. Name of the method is getName. So it is the same name as it is mentioned inside the base class, and also same return type. And similarly, the getName, we have written another getter method inside the derived class. We called it getValueDoubled. Okay, so by this name, there is a no functions is written in the base class, so there will be no issue. Only one function is common between these two class. The name of the function is called getName. In the derived, it has own implementation, and getName inside base has its own implementation. Okay, let's look at the main method here. What we did, we have created a derived class object, and we have passed 5 to the derived class constructor. So once we 5 pass to the derived class constructor here, then Internally, using the initializer list, we have called the base class constructor, and base part of the derived class object get value this file. That means m underscore value of the base class is initialized by 5. Thereafter, what we did, we have used derived class object to call the member function getName. GetName is a member function of derived class, so it's going to return me that string called derived. Thereafter, we called getValue method using the derived class object. So derived class object doesn't have any method name called getValue directly. So what derived class object going to do? Derived class object going to call this function from its base part. Okay, so from its base part, what this base part is have? Base part has a value of 5, and it also has these two member function as part of the derived class. So this get value get called from the base part of the derived class. So it's going to print a value 5. Next, what we did, we have assigned this derived to the reference of the derived class. So we know from the reference point of view, reference is what? LValue reference is an alias of a variable. So means now this R derived, which is an alias or LValue reference of the derived class, is also pointing the same memory block which is pointed by the derived. Sorry, which have the same refer the same memory block, which I should not use the pointing word, which is referring the same memory block. Means now derived and R derived is an alias to each other. Both are going to access the same memory block. So same thing will happen here. We are using R derived is what? R derived is an reference of the derived class, and it's going to call the same function like derived class object getName, and then it also going to call the getValue method. So like object, while it's going to calling these two function reference, it also gets the same kind of behavior here. Means getValue method is not available in the derived class, but it's going to be called from the base class part. At last, we have created a pointer of the derived class, and we have assigned the address of the derived class object. So when we create a pointer of the derived class, it gets a separate memory here. So this is suppose of the pointer p derived, and p derived is pointing an object which is previously created. It's pointing an object. A derived class object will have two parts. One will be the base part, another will be the derived part. Next, what we did, we have assigned the address of the derived class object to the derived class pointer. So now value of this pointer will be the address of the derived class object. Suppose address of the derived class object will be 2000, so then this 2000 will be kept by this pointer. Next, what we did, we call the getName member function using the pointer of that class. So for that purpose, we are using arrow operator, and again we have called the getValue method, which is not available in the derived class. So getValue method get called from the base part using the derived class pointer. So what do you understand here? We understand that we can call a base class method using the derived class object, as well as derived class reference, as well as derived class pointer. Okay. In the next lecture, we're going to see, can we get the same thing or not using base class pointer. Okay, we're going to see, can we use a base class pointer to call the derived class part. Okay, so what will be the output that you're expecting after execution of this code? So let's look at the output here. See, when we call the derived class method using derived class object, we are also getting the name of the derived class object. But when you call derived class method using derived class reference, we're also getting the same output. And when you call a derived class method using a derived class pointer, again you are getting the same output. So same thing we are achieving using three different ways: one using the derived class object, one using derived class reference, and another using derived class pointer. So in the next lecture, we're going to discuss about can we get the same thing using a base class pointer and reference, which is going to point a derived class object.